now it's 15:22 or 3:22 p.m. if you say it in English. In Denmark we use all the numbers, so we say from 0 to 24, not like in British or American, where they only say from 1 to 12. But it's afternoon and we are at the end of this race, the last hour. The UCI Gran Fondo Time Trial World Championship. And now it's the youngest age groups who we see. They are only from 19 to 34 and not from 18 to 34, as I said earlier. I think it's a bit odd that they have an age limit that is 19 and not 18. I don't really get that. That's a bit odd. Why not 18? Why 19? That's in Italian. But the riders who are approaching the finish line now are the second youngest group from 35 to 39. So, but the riders who are starting now, this 33 kilometer long course, they are the youngest ones from 19 to 34. They're almost like kids compared to some of the older ones I saw earlier today. They were in their 70s, some of them, even 80s. You can also see they are faster, these riders, this Norwegian. They're younger and faster. The oldest one rode at around 30, maybe 35 kilometers an hour. Yeah, Polish rider, and we see the youngest one, it must be around 45 kilometers an hour, maybe even a little bit faster. We know when the profs have their time trials, they ride 33 kilometers in around maybe half an hour, a little bit more than a half an hour. So that's close to 60 kilometers an hour, or at least 55. So I guess the best ones here of the younger ones, maybe it's 45, maximum 50 kilometers an hour, I don't know. But certainly they are quite a bit faster than the older guys, which is totally normal and logical. Here, Danish rider. Yes, I did film some of the older guys earlier today, and I decided, oh, I also need to film a bit of the younger guys. Sorry that I didn't get the middle-aged guys from 40 to 55, but I just found it was too hard to stand here for the whole day because it's so hot and a bit humid today. Now the temperature has it's even higher now. Now it's 27, 28 in the shadow, and certainly more than 30 in the sun. But luckily, at least for me, in my opinion, we have a bit of clouds now, so there's shadow almost everywhere. So this makes it a bit nicer, at least in my opinion. Very fast, this French guy. And also this Finnish guy. Now they really ride fast, like almost like the Tour de France profs. Not quite, but almost. Of course, they are not quite as good as the riders we see at the World Tour, on the World Tour. If they had been that, of course, they would not have taken place in this amateur race. Here, a Danish rider. Yeah, a guy who finished his race a little bit major than the other ones we saw now. These are young riders, remember that? No one is older than 34. So they are even a few years younger than I am. I can reveal I am middle-aged. I'm not young, but also not old, at least not yet. Middle-aged. So these guys are younger than me, and the ones we saw earlier today are older than me. So we didn't actually see the guys my age. Because I took a break when they rode, but I didn't feel like watching the whole race because it would be like 5-6 hours, a little bit, no, 7 hours. They started at 9 a.m. and they will finish at 4 p.m. There we have some friends, fans with friends flag. Good luck, Turkish guy here. Oh, there's even a little bit of wind now. That feels nice. I think about going to the finish line area, but it's a bit hotter there because there's more people and because it's a little bit more difficult to find shadow there. So I'm not really sure if I want to go there. Also here, it's a nice place. Forza Italia! Buona fortuna! It was an Italian guy, so I shouted Buona fortuna, that means good luck in Italian. Yes, I do speak Italian. I've never lived in Italy, but once I worked for an Italian company, so I do speak Italian. Dai, 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 dai. A black man. We don't see so many black riders in professional cycling. A Portuguese. But of course we have Biniam Girmay from Eritrea, who won the green jersey at the Tour de France. It's nice to see also riders from Africa emerging now. Of course they also have talents in Africa. The problem is they don't really have the finances and the infrastructure, so this means it's difficult for a young talented rider from Africa to emerge. But that doesn't mean that they don't have the talent. And another pretty obvious thing is that in Africa, of course, they don't have so many bikes, so that means that you don't have so many riders when you don't have so many bikes. So that's pretty logical, I think. Belgium, they really dominate the pro tour cycling, have a lot of stars. Probably Belgium is the best cycling nation in the world right now. And Denmark is also among the best, fourth or fifth place on the world ranking right now. But Belgium has to be the number one. So many great riders, Evenepoel, Van Aert and so. But of course Denmark, we also have Mads Pedersen, Jonas Vingegaard, Jakob Fuglsang, Magnus Kort, Michael Valgren, Søren Krav, Kasper Asgren, Andreas Kron, Mathias Gjelmose. Yes, we also have a few very good riders here in Denmark. On the opposite side of the road, of course, we have the starters. A very young looking French guy. He looks almost like 18, but the youngest one are 19. Maybe he's 19. I don't know where he's from. Blue and yellow, could be Sweden or Ukraine or something like that, but I'm not sure. This must be a French rider, and it is. Especially Belgium and France have a lot of riders. I talked about Danish riders. We only also have two local riders from this part of Denmark who are pretty famous. One is Michael Valgren. And the other one is, of course, Jonas Vingegaard. They are not from Aalborg, but they are from this region. They were both born and grew up about 80-90 kilometers from Aalborg, so not so far away. And Vingegaard, when he was young, he actually rode for Aalborg Cycling Ring, the cycling ring in this city. So Vingegaard has actually been riding here in Aalborg for the local team when he was a teenager, I think. But I have never seen Vingegaard, but my parents saw him last year. They were in Skive, close to where Vingegaard lives, and they saw him walking on the street with his wife. So if you are lucky, you can actually see Vingegaard somewhere here in northern Denmark sometimes. That looks like a Dutch rider, orange. Oh, three riders after each other. Nice pace there from this Belgian guy. Now I am very close to the finish line and start line, and all the riders are now on the road, or at least the ones who have not finished the races yet. So either they have all finished or they are on the road now. Nobody is yet to start. Everyone has started. Here, rider approaching the finish line. Of course, if they have the energy, they will take a sprint, very high pace here from this Belgian guy.
Allez, allez.
Allez, allez, Belgium. These guys have finished the race, of course.
From Belgium came in at third place.
Third place for him. Nice effort. And he actually did look very fast. So he is now on the third place in the category 35 to 39 years of age, the Belgian guy we just saw. And now two other guys are approaching the finish line. It must still be from 35 to 39. The next group is the youngest one, they will come after. Yes, we can see they are very fast, these younger riders. Of course, in my opinion also, the older ones were pretty fast. At least they are still faster than me, but the youngest one are really very, very fast. Here are some riders who are done, who have finished their race today. I guess many of them, if not all of them, will also take part in the road race on Sunday. But I actually don't know. It could be that some of them only take part in the time trial. And here we can see two other riders approaching the finish line. It should still be the 35 to 39 age category. I think he was from Slovenia, or was it Slovakia? Slovakia. And the next one, maybe South Africa. Number 20 and number 40. So the Slovak guy was number 20 and the South African guy number 40. So not close to the middle, but still, still a nice effort. I heard it's a Belgian guy who is number one and a Norwegian number two in the 35 to 39 years category. And the time was 40 minutes something. Pretty impressive. Almost as fast as the profs. They're not much slower actually than the profs. But maybe even if they are 3 minutes slower, that means of course all the difference. Number five, the Liechtenstein guy we just saw. Is he from Italy or what? No, I don't think so. Maybe France? I'm not sure. There's one error. We don't see the names. There should be a screen, a display with the names, but we don't see that. So we have to rely on the speaker's information. But then I'm here just to enjoy the race. It doesn't matter so much for me who wins and who doesn't win. This is, after all, just an amateur race, so the most important thing is to take part. Of course, it's also nice to win, but everyone here is a winner, in my opinion. Even the ones who finish on the last spots are still winners, in my opinion. Because it's not a professional race, so it's nice just to take part.
Group of 35 to 39.
I don't think I will stay here to the end because it will still take some time. The German guy
here from Germany, Dennis Becker, came in place number 39. It's gonna be a gold medal to Jari Verstraten from Belgium.
It was a Belgian guy who won in front of a Norwegian guy. But I didn't get the Belgian guy on the screen. But I got the third placed guy at least. Here we see a guy sprinting towards the finish line, very high pace. A lot of watts going through his pedals. It is an Austrian guy. Nice performance.
Daniel Hupfraser.
A Polish guy. An Italian guy. These are all the young guys from 19 to 34. So that's also why they are so fast.
France.
A French guy.
Currently in first place in the young riders category, 92.
Was it a third place? I'm not sure. What he said. It's really hot here. Still sweating just by standing still. I can't imagine the guys who are riding. But actually when you ride, maybe it feels not so bad because you can feel the wind and the wind gives a little bit of shadow, you can say, not shadow, but cooling effect.
Antonius Sturman from Holland.
I also rode my bike to this place and it felt better than standing here because when you stand then you don't really feel the cooling effect.
On fourth place and fifth place.
It was a fourth and a fifth place for them. When I have made this video, maybe I will try to find out who have won all the different classes, if it's possible to get this information on internet. I will post a list so you can see who won and who came second and third. A German rider.
84 years old. It's Camila Buchanan from the US.
Not so much people here for this race, but there are a few hundreds spectators. I'm expecting more spectators Sunday for the road race. The road race will start and end in the central Aalborg, so just for this reason you will expect much more people watching the race. Two riders more approaching the finish line here. A Belgian guy. And two more here. Oh, nice sprint there. It was a silver for... Was this the American guy? I'm not sure. And a bronze medal for the other one. An Italian guy. I think the race is almost finished now. I'm not sure. There can't be many riders left. Since he's always talking about who took the medals, this means they must be close to the end.
55-59 in the female category, Elizabeth Fox.
Oh, actually, he's just he's just telling all the classifications now. So maybe I should listen.
Category 50-54, Adelheid Schütz is taking the gold medal from Germany. Molly van Hoolen from
Go, 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 go! Nice effort by this American.
Today's fastest female rider, Sonja Moy from Norway, is getting the gold in the women's category 45-49.
Great effort! Polska, Polska, Polska!
Getting the silver medal, Bettina Kramer from Denmark is getting the bronze medal. The female category.
So many riders now, it's impossible to get all of them on my camera.
Emily is grabbing a gold medal, and Alina Bosna from Holland is getting a silver, and Bianca Christensen from Denmark is getting a bronze. And in the young riders category, 19-24 years old, Jessica Wolfgang from the United Kingdom takes the gold medal, Eiko Kinderman from Belgium is second, and Denise Sawyer from Austria is first.
I think the only classification that is still not decided should be the ones for the youngest male riders.
Last group of the men, the youngest group, 19-34 years old, currently led by Daniel Hochstrasser from Austria. We have Thomas Steffens from Germany across the finish line. Sixth place
for that German guy. It's an Austrian guy who leads this race for the youngest male riders. And it's a Danish rider who's number three.
And for Daniel Hochstrasser, who's number one at the moment, that's the fourth best time of the day.
They are so fast, these riders.
Powering all the way to the finish line.
They almost look like Van Aert and De Vennepoel.
Second place for Dennis Bidua.
It was the second place for the first of the two guys who just crossed the line. Who knows how many riders we have left now on the road? Could it be 5, 10, 20? I don't know. It could not be, should not be so many. Such a nice sprint here. Is that a German guy? No. And the Danish guy?
Johannes Rondan, Lomo Vitingen. He's coming in and clicking in on the first time so far in the young group. 40 minutes, 32 seconds. Johannes Rondan.
Oh, exactly. The Danish guy, Johannes Romdahl, I think he's local guy, maybe from Aalborg. I think he's from Aalborg. He is now number one.
In 22 and 23,
I think I heard that name before somewhere. So he's a little bit known here in the area.
Now Johannes Romdahl is riding the Grand Prix World Championship, category 19 to 30.
So it's now a Danish guy who leads this race. Interesting. By Johannes Rondahl.
Time trial bike. And that's the best time of the day. 7 seconds ahead of Jari Mastrana.
And it was the best time of the day among all the riders. So not a bad effort. But of course he's a young man. So of course he should be able to beat older men who are 80, 70, 60 and so on.
We have start number 46, so all the rest of the riders now know what to chase. It's a Dane, Johannes Rondahl.
Here we see another rider towards the finish line. No better for him, I think. Not so fast as the other ones we just saw. Tomorrow we also have an event here. It's a team time trial that will take place in Central Aalborg. I don't know if I will go and see that. I will decide that tomorrow if I feel like it. But I think I will be here again, at least Sunday, for the road race. We see that guy had number 44 and the guy who is in the front, he has number 46. So he overtook that guy and still was at the finish line 5 minutes before, something like that. Pretty impressive by Johannes Rondahl. It was a provisional sixth best time for the guy we just saw crossing the finish line. And in the meantime, another guy is approaching the finish line. He also looks pretty fast, but is this fast enough? I'm not sure about that. An Italian guy. Un ragazzo italiano.
Claudio Mandrioli from Italy.
What was his time?
The last air he did to cross the finish line.
El suo tempo, pare?
At a position as number 15.
Quindicesimo posto per il ragazzo italiano. 15th place for the Italian rider. And here,
another rider.
His last effort. A Danish rider.
Great race by the Dane Lucas Ingman Thompson.
Lucas Thompson something.
Seventh place
for him, not bad at all. That guy has some fans here. What about his time?
From Spain. Number 20.
20th place. So I guess these guys in front of me must be from Spain, since they cheered so much for him. I don't zoom so much in now, because when they approach the finish line, if I get too much zoom, then it's hard to follow the riders. So I only have 30% zoom now.
Forza!
Another Italian rider.
Lorenzo Melvignano is coming on 10th place.
Un altro corridore italiano al traguardo, ma fuori dalle prime posizioni, outside the first positions. Two riders now, no, three, in the bottom of the screen here, giving their last towards the finish line.
Coming in almost in a bunch, giving in everything.
A Polish, an Austrian guy, and French maybe, I'm not sure.
Maxime Limon from France, coming in at fourth place.
The French guy, number four.
Austria. He came in at number 20, and then we have Marcin Kabowski from Poland, he came in as number 6.
So a fourth and a sixth place for two of the three guys who just crossed the finish line. Here's somebody who has finished the race. Come so.
Dora Lazarus from Bosnia and Herzegovina. Came in as number 31.
31 place for the Bosnian Herzegovinian guy here. Belgian guy with glasses. You don't. It must be sunglasses, I suppose.
Victor de Baer from Belgium. And we only have around 35, 40 riders left out there, so in less than 20 minutes it will be over. So
oh, we still have almost 40 riders, that's impressive. I didn't know there were so many riders left. There must be a very long list of riders among the youngest ones. But of course, this age group ranges from 19 to 34, so it's a 15 years gap. So there must be three times so many riders in this group as in the other groups, because the age range is three times bigger. Because in all the other groups we only have 5 years of age range between the riders. Maybe a Spanish guy.
Really a fast pace here for the German Daniel Herrmann.
No, a German.
On the last part of the course, 27th place.
27th? I thought he was a Spaniard because there were Spanish people cheering for him, but of course they can also cheer for guys who are not from Spain.
And two riders going head to head for the last 100 meters of the time trial. With the German Tobias Eis in front, going in at 10th place, and Ferhat Dilanović from Bosnia-Herzegovina going in at place number 34. Pushing, we are pushing here in the practice. Sebastian van der Fulenberg and Eduardo Bazzarini from Italy going in at place 20, place 38. Diego Piera.
I think I'll probably just Google the result and then tell the result, because I didn't expect so many riders were still left, and I think it's a little bit hard to stand here in this heat, and I also have to go home. That's a Dane. We hear blues. Bruce Springsteen in the background. Very nice sprint there. Go, 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 go!
Fast pace here from The Czech guy, Tomáš Kudela.
Czech, yeah. Czech Republic.
Number 13.
13. I think I'll see one or two riders more, then I will leave, because it's really hot here, and I also have to go home. That's also
tomorrow,
a ride.
25 teams are going to do the team relay in Almore Center. It's going to be a great fun. It's going to be the first time in Grand Fondo history that they're going to do a world championship in team relay.
That's also going to be interesting tomorrow with 25 teams taking part at the team relay in Central Aalborg. I'll just take one or two riders more, then I will go. But I will tell you the result if I can find them. Go, go, go!
All they want to start in, so 25 riders are starting in a bunch, and then they change after three rounds to rider number two, and then three rounds to rider number three, and then three rounds to rider number four. First team doing 12 laps with four different riders is world champions. It's gonna be a spectacular sight tomorrow by the harbor in Aalborg, so please come and join us if you like a good drama and like a good cycle race. And then Sunday is the big road race. Also we start and finish in the middle of Aalborg by the big church, where we'll crown this year's world champion in road racing, Grand Fondo Road Race.
And actually I have decided to leave now, even that we have almost 20 riders left. I think it's too hot to stand here. I've been here for an hour and I also took like 20 minutes to get here. So it's 2 hours out in this heat, 28 degrees in the shadow. And I was also here earlier today, so I think it's a little bit too much sun for me. But we'll take one or two riders more here when they are approaching the last corner. Right corner before the finish line. But I still think that I have seen some nice cycling today, even that I didn't watch it to the finish, to the end. Here a French guy. But here is a little bit more windy and open, so actually it's more comfortable to stand here. Start to feeling better after I wouldn't call it a heat stroke, but certainly suffering a bit in the heat. A Belgian guy. But we don't get those riders timed because now we can't hear the speaker. But here we see them from another angle. It could also have been nice to be around the route somewhere and film them, but it's not easy to get there because, of course, the road is closed. So it's a little bit difficult to get there. And also in this heat, I would have to ride a long ride to go outside Aalborg to see them. So it's okay just to stand here. A Belgian guy. But it has been a nice event. Some spectacular riding here and racing. Go, 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 go! A French guy, a lot of French riders here. Actually here it doesn't feel so hot at all as near the finish line, because near the finish line there are so much people. And also, there you just stay in the sun. Here is a little bit nicer, in my opinion. So now I actually stopped suffering just by moving to this place where the sun is not so sharp and cruel. A Belgian guy. But okay, I'll try to find the results somewhere on the internet, and then I'll post them when I upload this second video. It's my second video from this time trial. I made a video, the first video from the time trial, just before I went here for the second part of the race. So that first part of the race is already uploaded on my channel. Here another rider. No, just a normal average guy riding on his bike. But in the very bottom of the road I can see somebody approaching. Actually two riders approaching here. They must be among the last 10 riders, because 10 minutes ago the speaker told there were 20 riders left, so now it must be maximum 10. A black guy here. But where is he from? I don't know. Go, go, go! Nice effort! Forza dai, ce la puoi fare, vincerai! Just kidding. I shouted to him in Italian, go, 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 you can make it, you can win. But of course, I don't know if he can win. Here another rider approaching, two riders again. Another friends. So many Frenchmen today. Oh, a Juventus fan. I'm actually also a Juventus fan. So that's why that's interesting. Is it Vlahovic shirt? I'm not sure. Dusan Vlahovic. Here another rider approaching the last right corner before crossing the finish line. That's a really nice effort here. Oh, another French guy. There are so many Frenchmen and Belgian guys here. Actually, I was also thinking about going and see the victory ceremony, but I won't do that because it will also take some time. And I know that it's so hot near the finishing line. So I don't know if there are any more riders left. It could be that the Frenchman before was the last one. Who knows? Okay, the French guy was not the last rider. I see another guy coming here. And I think it will be the last one I will watch. Then I'll leave. And I will try to see if I can find the results, and I will post them when I post my second video from this time trial. Go, 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 go! Have a nice day and thanks for watching this UCI Grand Fondo time trial event from Aalborg in Denmark. Actually, we have two riders more here, so I'll just take them. It could be the last two. Why do I think that? I think that because there is a police motorcyclist behind them and two cars, and the presence of the cars behind the motorcyclist is a clear indication of these riders being the last ones. Go, 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 go! A French guy. I'm sure they must be the last guys, because now the road is open again. Thanks for watching. At the end, I did watch the race until the finish. Have a nice day. Hello, I just came home after watching the USI
Grand Fondo time trial race. And the results are already online. We saw that in the men's 19 to 30 years old category, when I left the race, Johannes Romdahl from Denmark was leading the race. But actually, he was overtaken by, of course, a Belgian guy. The Belgians, they always win, the Belgians. The Belgians always win. Guillaume Say, that sounds French, but we know there's also a French-speaking minority of Belgians. Guillaume Say won the gold, number two, Johannes Romdahl from Denmark, and bronze, Camille Notebert. That's also some French, but again, a Belgian guy. And if you look at the time, 40 minutes, exactly 40 minutes and 1 second for the winner, Guillaume Say. That's an average pace of 49.66 kilometers an hour. That's incredibly fast. It's not much slower than the elite guys from the World Tour. But of course, the elite guys from the World Tour would have done maybe 53, 54. And if you see it in that way, of course, that is a big difference. But still, these efforts are still pretty impressive. But let's try to look at the results from the other events as well. We take now the women's race, 19 to 34, and we can see that the gold medal was won by the British lady Jessica Rose Jones in front of Elke Tiberman from Belgium and Denise Zöhrer von Austria. And the average pace for the woman, the youngest category, 43 kilometers per hour. That's still pretty impressive, but of course lower than the men. And of course I'm Danish, so I also notice at the third place Frederikke Asfeldt from Denmark. Now let's look at the results from the women's second youngest category or age group from 35 to 39. The gold medal was won by the German Kimberly Miller in front of Annelien Bosma from Netherlands, and the bronze medal went to the Danish woman Bianca Christiansen. And also here, pretty impressive times, almost as fast as the younger women, only 1 kilometers per hour slower. And as a Dane, it's nice to see two Danes in the top five, also Anna Damgaard Eriksen at the fifth place. And how did it go with the men's race for the same age group, 35 to 39? As we saw when I was at the event, there was a Belgian guy who was leading. I didn't get him on film, on camera. Jari Verstraeten from Belgium won in front of Vidar Mehl from Norway. Vidar Mehl, I think it's the right pronunciation. And again, another Belgian guy, Sander Ehlen, at the third place. And also here, impressive times. 48.89 kilometers per hour. And it's actually only 38 seconds slower than the guy who won in the youngest male category. So that's pretty interesting. So maybe the guys from 35 to 39 should just have rode in together with the youngest guys, since they were almost as good as the youngest guys. Now we go to the third oldest category, or first youngest, of course, 40 to 45, and I didn't watch any of these riders, but the gold medal went to an Irish guy called Paul Kennedy in front of Norwegian Reidar Borgesen, and a Dane on the third place, Jeppe Tolbøl. And also here, pretty impressive times, not much slower than the younger guys. If you look at the women, for this age group. The gold medal went to a Swedish woman, Cecilia Hansen. That sounds actually more Norwegian or Danish. Silver and bronze to Poland, Anna Strasowska. I don't know, how do you pronounce that? R-R-Z-A-Z-R-R-Z-S-K-U-V-A. I don't know. And but bronze medal to Alina Milka. Her Polish is a very difficult language if you are Dane. I don't really know how to speak Polish. Let's see, how did it go for the men between 40 and 45, 44? An Irish gold medal to Paul Kennedy. And a Norwegian silver medal, Reidar Borgesen. Oh, we already looked at that, so we will not look at that again. Let's jump to the next category, 45 to 49. Sorry for that mistake. The men's gold medal for this age category went to British guy Matthew Ronald William Smith. Second place for another Dutch guy, Bart van Dieren. And the bronze medal to Torbjørn Inger from Norge. Lololo, det er Norge. Og Norge vinner. Det er bronze medal for Norge. I just make fun of the Norwegian. They are always very enthusiastic about sport. Just kidding. For the women's category, they really had something to be enthusiastic about in Norway. For the age group 45 to 49, a gold medal for Sonja Moi from Norge. Og Norge vinner. Vi er verdens beste. Norge er verdens beste. Norge har vunnet. Det er gold for Norge. Just make fun of the Norwegians. They are so funny. And a silver medal for the German lady, Naomi Rebecca de Pennington. And bronze medal for Denmark, Bettina Kramer. And also pretty good average pages here, as you can see. See. Now we move on to the category 40 to 40. No, 50 to 54. And here, gold medal for Germany in the women's category, Adelheid Schütz. Second place for USA, Molly van Hoveling. That sounds Dutch, but she must be of a Dutch origin. And third place for Belgium, Marieke de Schmidt. And how did it go with the males for this category, 52-54? The gold medal to a Spanish guy, Raúl Patiño Delgado. Second place for Latvia, Geerts Wevers. And third place for Richard Brook. And we have a Danish guy, Martin Mølgaard Ravn, on the fourth place. Let's move on to the men's category, 55 to 59, getting older and older. Oh, I missed something here. Let's see who won. Mario Cipollini. I didn't know he was in this race. If I had known that Mario Cipollini was taking place in this race, I would of course have looked at the race. So on Sunday, I will try to be very observant to see if I can see Mario Cipollini on Sunday's race. I'm a little bit sorry that I missed Mario Cipollini. Some will say, oh, he was dope and so, but anyway, still a great rider. Second place to Robert Emil Nunes An from, what is that, CRC? That must be Croatia, I think. Oh no, that is Costa Rica. That is why the name sounds Spanish, Robert Emil Nunes An. Third place to Richard Oakes from Great Britain. Very interesting, Mario Cipollini took place in this race. I didn't have a clue about that. What about the women's 55 to 59 years category? Gold medal for the USA, Elizabeth Fox. Second place again to an American, Jane Despas. Third place to the Italian, Antonella Incristi. No really, I don't see any names that I remember here. But I can't say for sure that none of them, these riders have been ex-professionals, because I don't know all riders. Women's category 60 to 64. Gold and silver medal for Denmark. Very nice for Denmark. Karen Hvide Christensen, gold medal. Pia Schultz Lorentzen, silver medal. And an Italian bronze medal for Olga Gabriello. and also a fifth place for Denmark, Janni Bormann. Nice pace, 40 kilometers an hour, almost 41. Let's look at the women. Let's look at the men. Sorry for being a little bit confused. Maybe I'm tired. I'm actually preparing my food now, starting to be hungry. Gold medal for Kevin Tai from Great Britain. A silver medal for Alan Nelson from Australia. And bronze medal for Laurit Thorning Jacobsen from Denmark. And Lars Ågaard Hansen, fifth place for Denmark. There is a young rider also called something with Ågaard Hansen. He took place in the Olympics on the track events. Maybe it's his dad, I'm not sure about that, but it's possible. And also here, nice pace, almost 46 kilometers per hour. It's impressive, even men at 60 to 64 are quite fast. I'm impressed about that. 65 to 69 years old men, but still young, because we see the winner also here, 43.5 kilometers on average, that's a good pace. From the winner from France, Daniel Miquel. Second place for Gonzalo Eguiguren Correa from Chile, and third place and bronze medal for Michael Barfod from Denmark. Let's see how the medal were placed among the women in this age category 65 to 69. We have first place for Linda De Wurst from Great Britain, and second place for the American Pat Wheatley Caldera, and third place and bronze medal for Lucia Borrowdale from Great Britain. And just about 40 kilometers on average for the winner. What a nice performance for a woman that age, 65 to 69. Now we jump on to 70 to 74 years old women. And now only three women took place. So if you started and finished the race, you were pretty sure to win a medal. Gold medal for France, Monique Dagon Brissel. Yeah, I'm not good at French. I speak Italian, Spanish, and so, but not French. How do you pronounce that surname? Brissel. Brissel. I don't know. But I can pronounce other names. Glenda Signorini, that's an Italian surname, even that she's Australian, second place. And third place for Giselle Thoureux from France. And here we see the average pace a lot lower here, but still pretty good pace for women aged 70 to 74, more than 30 kilometers an hour. I think that's still pretty good, but of course they are the best in the world in their age category, so you would expect them to be good. For the men aged 70 to 74, gold for the Frenchman Christian Bove, with a nice pace of 41.37. Silver medal for the American Paul Mowry, and bronze for Sweden Jan Jonsson. So the Swedes, they don't win much in the professional races, but in these amateur races they are not so bad, to be honest. Let's now look at the men from 75 to 79. And these were some of the guys I saw earlier today. Gold medal for André Petipas from France. Very impressive average pace, almost 40 kilometers an hour for a guy almost 80 years old. That's incredible. Silver medal for Finland, Matti Tanttu. And bronze medal for Poland, Piotr Jakubowski. Pretty impressive. Fifth place for the Dane, Johannes Riesbjerg. And how did it go? Yes, we can see here. I saw a family from Norway cheering for their granddad. So this must be one of these two guys. We see a Norwegian on the both on the 8th and the 9th place. 8th place here for Per Ole van Wijk, and the ninth place for Gunnar Fjellberg. So one of these guys must be the guy that the family cheered for in my first video I made from this event. And the women's category, 75 to 79. Only one person starts, so she just has to go through the course and she would win. And the gold medal went to France, Marie-Françoise Foss. But for a woman that aches 27 kilometers at on average, that's still pretty good, isn't it? I think it's very good. 84, still only one woman took part of this race, and it was won by the American Camilla Buchanan. How do you pronounce that? Buchanan. And she was even faster than the woman who won the category for 75 to 79. That's pretty impressive that the woman in the category from 80 to 84 was faster. 35 kilometers on average. That's insane. She must be a phenomenon. And how about the men in this category? Let's see the result. We saw some of the men in my first video that I made. Gold medal for France for Pierre Moreau. Still impressive average pace, 36.84. Silver medal for Robert Brown from Great Britain. Bronze medal for Marcel Eve from France. So now we move on to some of the last categories. The oldest one, 85 to 89. Let's see. Only four men started, so three of them won a medal. The gold went to Czechoslovakia. Oh, it's not Czechoslovakia anymore. Now it's just Czechia or Czech Republic. Petra Vatlach, 85 to 87, with an impressive average pace of 30.94 for a guy almost 90 years old. That's insane. Silver medal for Leon Malmed from the USA, almost as fast as the winner. And also very good performance by number three, Milan Matus, also from the Czech Republic. What do they eat in Czechia since they have so old guys who are so fast in Czechia? People must be very healthy in the Czech Republic. Women? Oh, there was only one woman, but she didn't even start, so no medals here. And I don't think there's anybody in the 90 to 94 category. No, there's no one. Even that is, there is this category, but no result found. So it was this. So pretty interesting to see this event. And now we got the results. And we can also, at the end, we can see all the results and age groups combined. We can see that the one who won the youngest group, Guillaume Say, he also had the best time among all the riders. And Johannes Romdahl, who won the silver medal for the youngest age group, also had the second best time. And the third best time went to Jari Verstraeten from Belgium, who won the 35 to 39 years age group. It impresses me that we have two 40 to 44 years old guys who are in the top five among all the riders. So they even beat a lot of the younger guys. But most impressive of all, maybe, Raúl Patiño Delgado from Spain. He won the 50 to 54 years old category. He had the ninth best time of all riders today, despite being more than 50 years old. Kudos to him. An incredible race. Of course, it's not Pedro Delgado, but I don't know about Raúl Patiño Delgado. Is this a famous rider? I don't know, but very impressive performance. Thanks for watching. This video became a little bit long, but I think it was very interesting also to go through the results. And we can see Mario Cipollini's effort also very impressive. He was number 18 among all the riders, despite being between 55 and 59 years old. So Mario Cipollini is still going strong. So I'm a little bit sorry about missing Cipollini, but I didn't know he took part in this race. If I had known about that, I would of course have tried to watch him. But still, pretty entertaining race. Have a nice day.